Welcome to this tutorial where I will show you how to make an animated curtain in Blender and export it to Unity. This is dedicated to Batuhan13 in the Unity forums who asked me to do this, so here it is. You start by adding a plane. This will be our curtain, and you have to add a few subdivisions to give it a bit more definition so it can bend and stretch. If you have just one plane, you can't deform the one polygon it has initially. So you can fine-tune this and add as many polygons as you like, but of course, if you want to use it in a game, it's best to keep the number small. Then we want to give this plane an initial shape. This is not looking like a curtain at all right now, so we are using the wave modifier, and you can always find many tutorials for every step I'm doing on YouTube and fine-tune it. I will show you just the general outline and the workflow. We are adding a wave here. You can see it if you are going in object mode, and yeah, you can play with these parameters and make it like that. So this is somewhat more similar to a curtain hanging from a wall. And if you're happy with the result, you can apply this, and so your mesh is deformed. And after that, we will rotate it 90 degrees to see it from the front, and after that with Control A you can apply the rotation. This is important later on. If you don't do this, the mesh keys you import back here can jump a bit around. So after we have this, we want this curtain to hang somewhere, so we have to define some fixed points, let's say here and here and here. You can always tweak this, you can make holes in it, and you can make it as beautiful as you like. The way we're doing this, we select our desired points here, and we add this as a vertex group, call this fixed, and assign those points to this group. So you can deselect, select, in this group you have those three points saved. Then we select the first point, and by clicking Shift and S we select cursor to select it, and then add in object mode, add an empty at this position. We will use this to animate those points later on. Then you have to look what points you also have. This one, Shift S, cursor to select it, and in object mode, add another empty. And the last one, this point, Shift S, cursor to select it, and add last empty object. Now you can add the cloth modifier. under the physics properties, select cloth. You have to select the plane, of course, for this. And you can play around with those parameters a lot. There are quite a few here, but again, there are many good tutorials for that. We have to set the pin group and select our fixed points, meaning those points won't be affected by the gravity at all. For example, if you go into object mode and play the simulation, you can see those are hanging fixed at those positions. Now we want to open this curtain using those nulls, and we can do this by animating those, but first we have to attach those points to these objects. So if we move this null object, this empty, this point knows, okay, I have to move with this empty. We can do this quite easily. Select this point and select the empty object for that, and then press Ctrl H and hook to selected object. By that, in object mode, you can select your empty and move it around, and you can see the point is moving with that empty. And of course, we have to do it for the other point as well. Select the empty, Ctrl H, and hook to selected object. Now we have to animate those null objects or empty objects. In the timeline, we go to frame 0, and first we play the animation a bit out. The curtain is hanging nicely and realistically, let's say at frame 50, and then we go to this empty, and in the location, just by hovering over it and pressing I, we're inserting a keyframe. You can see it here. And the other empty object as well, press I, and the position of this empty is saved in that keyframe. Then we advance, let's say 50 frames, and let's move that a bit, press I again, and a keyframe will be generated, and the second empty, move it as well. So you have to imagine a bit, and this is the end position of those points, and the cloth will follow in the simulation. You will see it soon. Press I again, and now you can see you have this animation of the empty objects. And if you play this out and let it simulate, you may be disappointed. And if you run into this error, this is because on your plane those hook modifiers we generated by pressing Ctrl H were now below the cloth modifier, and you have to make sure that the cloth modifier is the last modifier in this group. So the animation takes place first, and then the cloth calculations can take place. Let's play again. Now you can see everything is following nicely. We can then, in the cloth simulation, bake this animation, and now we can scrub through and We can fine-tune it, but for now I will keep it that way. You can also use some objects as the child object of those empties if you want a graphical representation like rings or something that are real objects of this curtain. What you can also do now is select the plane and use the smooth shading. It looks a bit nicer. And it may intersect and it may look a bit blocky, but you can always in the start make more subdivisions, and you can play with the physical properties. You can also activate object collisions and self collision, so this won't happen that much that it is intersecting. We can with this setting we can make another bake of the curtain. Takes a bit longer, but now we have a better solution, so we can keep it that way. Now you have to export the animation of this shape and import it back, so you have keyframes for every frame for that shape. You can't export the cloth modifier to Unity as far as I know, so you have to export the mesh deformation itself. And the way you can do it is using an export, a Lightwave point cache. If you don't have it here, you can look under preferences and under add-ons. You can search for MDD and you can activate it here. So you can export and import this format. So export this now and call it tutorial. Frame 1 to 250 or whatever you want. Now immediately after that we can re-import it. Also Lightwave point cache. And so there you go. You got now all those keyframes for this object, and what this is, it is shape keys. Meaning, if I go to the beginning here, you can see in frame number 2 this shape key is active, has a weight of 1, and all the other keys have a weight of 0. So in that frame the shape of the curtain is the mesh is formed like this. This is saved in this keyframe, and those we can export to Unity. But before we export this, we have to delete all the modifiers on this object, because otherwise it won't work. And we don't have to apply those, because we have all the shape data now in these keyframes. We can just delete them. We can't delete this. We have to go to the physics properties and reset it here. Now it is still playing because we have the data in the keyframes. Then you can export it as an FBX file. Let's call it tutorial. And here the important part is you only select the mesh. And maybe if you want to keep the empties to attach some objects in Unity, you may keep those, but right now we only need the mesh. And the important part is under bake animation, you have to make sure all actions and NLA strips is unchecked. Otherwise, Unity will have a lot of animation data, and not just this one animation data for the whole object. You can try it and see what the result is, but it only will work that way, in my experience, and I tried a lot. I forgot one thing, the export that may trouble you. There's a slider for simplify, and this means a few keyframes may get stripped out to make it more efficient and to save less data, so the file will get smaller, but this can lead to jerky movement. So if you experience some jerky movement, turn it to zero. So now in Unity we can import the FBX file. And as you can see, it's a nice shape, and if we play it, you can see it's not behaving so nicely. It's a lot of jitter in it. And this is because not only you can save a few frames of animation in Blender and on the export, but you can also save this animation frames in Unity. For example, the resample curves will change some animation frames, and the animation compression may reduce some frames as well, and you have to turn it off, those both settings, and hit apply. And now you have a smooth animation. If you put this in the scene now, firstly we see you can't see the backside because Unity only renders one side, but that's not a problem. And if you play, you won't see any animation because you have to trigger this animation. The object has an animator on it, but no animator controller, so you have to create an animator controller and use it in that animator. And if you double click on it, you can see what this animator controller does. Nothing so far, so you can select your animation in this FBX and right click in here, create a new state from selected clip. And now the entry action is you go to this state, and this state plays this motion. So if we play now, it vanishes. Why? The thing is that you can't place it somewhere in the scene because the animation keyframes will tell Unity, okay, in frame 0 I'm at position XYZ. So it will jump. You can see it if you play. It is here somewhere. That's not what we want, of course. You have to add an empty game object and then use this as a child. So this will be your controller for placement and for rotation, etc. And this will be local in its original state. For example, in Blender we exported it as at position 0, 0, 0, so you have to put it at that position, and also the rotation has to be 0. And if we play it now, you can see it stays there. And if you want to position it somewhere else, you have to use this game object. For example, rotate that game object, or place it somewhere else, or scale it maybe up. That's working nicely. And all you have to do now is to make a nice material in Blender or in Unity, and add some railings and some extras. And of course, you can make different animations from this clip. For example, this is just the hanging animation, and then you can make an opening animation, say from here to here. Yeah. And if you want to just play that, like I did in my game, you can use this clip in the animator and then trigger those states by different parameters that you can trigger in your C# scripts. That was it. If you have any questions, you can write on YouTube or in the forum, in the thread. I will post a link in YouTube to the thread. Thanks for listening.